हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ प्रोफेसर टीवी गुजराती, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, एसएनडी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड रिसर्च सेंटर, येवला। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सब्जेक्ट मटेरियल साइंस एंड मेटलर्जी इंजीनियरिंग। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट इज क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर एंड डिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ मटेरियल्स। So that we are going to study in proper manner today. So let's see the contents of this topic. So these are our contents. So first is basic concepts of crystal structure, types of crystal systems, then crystal structure of metals, that is BCC, FCC and HCP systems. Then lattice parameters, in that we are going to study coordination number, number of atoms per unit cell, atomic packing factor and density. Then we are going to study Miller indices and then indexing of lattice planes and direction. So these contents we are going to study step by step. So first of all, we'll study first point, that is basic concepts of crystal structure. Okay, so initially we'll try to understand the concept of this topic. So here you can see, here there is one flowchart is given. So here you can see from left hand side, so there is liquid metal is there. Initially you consider any product, you consider nut bolt. So if you want to manufacture, let us consider, if you want to manufacture nut, then you have to initially take its liquid metal. So first step in any product manufacturing, its liquid metal is there. Then we solidify that liquid metal. So when the liquid metal gets solidified, first of all unit cell is formed. So unit cell are having very small dimensions, that is 0.1 nanometers. So the unit cell may have any type of shape, that is body centered cubic, face centered cubic, hexagonal, close packed, or they may be allotropism. There may be allotropism, means they may be different kinds of cubic cells. Okay. So unit cells then comes together to form crystals. So these unit cells, many unit cells comes together to form one crystal, and then these crystals can be used to manufacture some products. You can use crystal as a single crystal, or either you can use as a polycrystal, correct? So these crystals may have some lattice imperfections and dislocations. So there may be some imperfections and some dislocations may be present. So the single crystals can be used in turbine blades. You might have heard turbine. So the turbine blades can be formed with the help of single crystals, or some solid state devices like semiconductor devices, where you can use single crystals. And these polycrystals, polycrystals means it is cluster of many crystals which is separated by grain boundaries. And if you apply some plastic deformation on these polycrystals, then you can manufacture any type of product like aircraft fusels, I-beams, some paper clips, bolts and springs. Like this you can make anything. So what is important here in this first chapter, we are going to study about these unit cells. What is unit cell and what is crystal structure? So how unit cell is formed and how crystal structure is formed. So what are the types of unit cell that we are going to study here? What are the imperfections in crystal, that we are going to study in next chapters. So like this we are going to study about unit cell and crystals. Okay, so we'll move further now. So these are some common materials. I want to introduce you to some common materials. So you can see here, ceramics is one of the common material. You might have heard ceramics. There are some ceramic pots are there, or your microwave oven. Some parts of microwave oven are also made up of ceramics because of its high temperature ability to withstand at higher temperature. This is one of the good property of ceramic. Then glass is there. Glass, you have seen everywhere glass. So structure of glass is amorphous. We'll discuss this amorphous in next slides. Then graphite. Graphite is made up of carbon. Its color is black, actually you can see. So graphite, you might have seen graphite electrodes in batteries. Again, pencils are made up of graphite, correct? So these are some crystals, single crystals are here. So these crystals are used in turbine blades, as I told you just now. Again, metals are there, different kind of metals are present, like aluminium, copper, steel. So these are some metals. And polymers are used in plastics. So plastic bags, polyvinyl chloride. So these are some what we can say, resins are there where we can use polymers. So these are some common materials which are used in day-to-day life. Okay, again I have shown here some common materials like metals and alloys. So first one is metals and alloys. So like this, copper, nickel, iron are some common examples. And metal may be in intermetallic compound also. Nickel, aluminium, this is one intermetallic compound. Then brass, it is alloy of copper and zinc, so it is also called as alloy. When two metals combine together, that is called as alloy. Then, as I told you, ceramic is formed by oxide, nitride or carbide of metals, like silicon carbide is one of the example of ceramics. Again, alumina is one of the example. Zirconia is one of the example of ceramics. Next common material is polymer. So polymers are having two important types, thermoplast and thermosets, as well as there is one more type is there, elastomers. So examples are here, polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride, polypropylene. So these are some examples of polymers. Again, there is some type, it's based on electrical conduction, like conductors, semiconductors, insulators. As you know, copper, aluminium are good conductors of electricity. Semiconductor is there. Alumina, polyethylene are insulators which do not conduct electricity. Again, there are some types based on ductility. Some materials are ductile, some materials are brittle. So metals and alloys are ductile. Ceramics, glasses are brittle in nature. Okay, so these are some common materials. Just I have told you these common materials to get familiar with our subject, because we are going to study about materials and metallurgy. Okay, so we'll see next. So we'll see some basic concepts of crystal structure. So study of properties of metals by structure. So any metal you take, like copper, aluminium, nickel, so every metal is having some different properties. So those properties are based on their structure. Structure means crystal structure, what is inside that material, that shows its properties. So there are some solids are there, types of solids. Two types of solids are present. One is crystalline solid. So what is crystalline solid? It is built up of number of crystals, metals or non-metals. So when many crystals comes together, then crystalline solid is formed. So for example, iron, copper and aluminium is there. So again, we can see definition. Crystalline structures may be single crystal or aggregate of many crystals, known as polycrystalline. And those crystals are separated by well-defined boundary. There is well-defined boundary is present. And second type is non-crystalline solid. So these are non-crystalline in structure. So whatever structure is there, it is not in regular pattern. That's why it is called as non-crystalline in structure. So these non-crystalline solids are also called as amorphous materials. For example, glass, wood and plastics, these are example of non-crystalline solids. So this concept will be clear more in next slide, because with the help of some figure we are trying to clear it. So here you can see, so this is crystalline silica, it is called as quartz, and below that there is non-crystalline silica, it is called as glass. So here you can see there is periodic arrangement of atoms is present, means you can see hexagons are repeated in regular pattern here. But in lower figure there are not hexagons, so there are some pentagons, some heptagons, so and there is no regular arrangement of atoms. That's why it is called as non-crystalline. So in crystalline materials, atoms pack in periodic and three-dimensional arrays. So there is periodic arrangement is there. So examples are metals, ceramics and some polymers shows crystalline structure. And what is non-crystalline materials? The atoms having no periodic packing, those are called as non-crystalline materials. So examples are, as I told you earlier, glass is there, plastic materials are there, wood is example of non-crystalline materials. So these are examples of non-crystalline materials. They occurs because of complex structure, they are having complex structures. And rapid cooling, when you cool the material from higher temperature to lower temperature very rapidly, then such a structure is formed. And these are called as amorphous, that is non-crystalline materials. Okay, so this is the difference between crystalline materials and non-crystalline materials. So we'll move further. So we are going to some study definitions. So first definition here is crystal structure. So what is crystal structure? It is defined as many unit cells repeat in three-dimensional space. This is very simplified definition. So when many unit cells, means small unit cells, repeat in three-dimensional space, then whatever structure is formed, that structure is called as crystal structure. Now second definition is space lattice, or it is also called as point lattice. It is defined as infinite array of points in three-dimensional space. So in three-dimensional space, when points are there in x, y, z direction, so whatever that array of points is there, it is called as space lattice. Every point is located symmetrically with respect to other. In this array, every point is located symmetrically with respect to other, means one point is symmetrical to adjacent points, means whatever neighboring points are there, all are symmetrical to each other. So that is one of the advantage of this space lattice. Next definition is unit cell. So unit cell is nothing but basic structural part in the composition of materials. So suppose there is one material is there, aluminium. So aluminium will have one crystal structure, and that crystal structure may have many unit cells. So out of those unit cells, one unit cell is called as basic structural part in the composition of materials. So that is called as unit cell. So you will understand these three figures, these three definitions, with the help of one figure. Okay, so this figure indicates one unit cell. So it is like one cube is there. Cube is having six sides and eight corners, and there are three axes are there, x, y and z axis. So this is called as one unit cell, that is basic structural part in the composition of materials. Okay, so again you will understand properly from this figure. So here you can see this part, this entire structure is nothing but one crystal structure. So it is made up of small unit cells. So whatever this green part is there, it is called as one unit cell. And at each corner of this unit cell, you can see there are some points are there. So those are called as lattice points. So when this one unit cell repeats itself in three dimensional, then crystal structure is formed. So this is called as entirely, we call it as crystal structure. This green part is called as unit cell, and whatever these points are there, only points, those are called as space lattice, or it is also called as point lattice. Okay, so like this difference is there: unit cell, space lattice, and crystal structure. So I want to tell you one more thing here. This unit cell represents entire crystal structure, because this unit cell is identical everywhere. So if you want to study any material, so rather than studying entire crystal structure, you can study only this small unit cell also. So this unit cell will tell you properties of entire crystal structure and of that entire material. So what is the property of material, you will understand with the help of this unit cell only. So from the next slide onwards, we are going to study about these unit cells. Okay. So again, here in different manner definition is given. So what is crystal? Crystal is nothing but combination of lattice and motif. So what is lattice? Lattice is nothing but the underlying periodicity of the crystal. Okay, and what is basis or motif? It is entity associated with each lattice points. Okay, so motif is nothing but atom or group of atoms associated with each lattice points. It is called as basis or motif. So in short, what is lattice? It is how to repeat. And what is motif? What to repeat. So how to repeat means what? There is array of points. So in that array we have to repeat. And what to repeat? We have to repeat atoms here, atom or group of atoms. Then the crystal will get formed. So here you can see also lattice is nothing but translationally periodic arrangement of points. There is arrangement of points is there. Translationally means what? Linear arrangement of points. When that point is get replaced by motif, then crystal is formed. So what is crystal? Translationally periodic arrangement of motifs. Motif means atom or group of atoms. Okay. So you will understand this definition with the help of one figure. So here you see, here it is lattice. It is nothing but array of points, translational arrangement of points. And what is basis or motif? It is one flower is there. Flower means one atom is there. When the points are replaced by this atom, then crystal structure is formed. So this is crystal structure. So there is regular arrangement of points, and those points are replaced by atoms, then crystal structure is formed. So this is very simplified image or concept is there. So like this crystal structure is formed. Okay, so now next thing is crystal systems. So here also one definition is given of unit cell. So unit cell is nothing but smallest repetitive volume which contains the complete lattice pattern of a crystal. So unit cell is nothing but smallest repetitive pattern or smallest repetitive volume which contains the complete lattice pattern of a crystal. So as I told you earlier, so complete lattice pattern can be studied with the help of this small volume, that is small unit cell can be studied. So here you can see, here one unit cell is there, correct? So here you can see along x axis the length of unit cell is A, along y axis length of unit cell is B, and along z axis length of unit cell is C. So these are called as edges of the unit cell. So there are edges are there. So length of edge along x axis is A, along y axis is B, and along z axis is C. As well as there are some angles are there. The angle between y and z is alpha. Angle between x and z axis it is beta. And angle between angle between x and y is gamma. So there are, you can see there are three angles and three lengths are there. So these lengths and these angles are called as lattice constants. Lattice constants, or they are also called as lattice parameters. So A, B, C and alpha, beta, gamma are called as lattice constants or lattice parameters. So depending upon these lengths A, B, C, alpha, beta, gamma, there are seven crystal systems are there. Seven main crystal systems are present. And if we go much deep, their subtypes we consider, then there will be total 14 crystal systems are there, or crystal lattices are present. So we are going to focus on only these seven crystal systems only. So let's discuss these crystal systems. So here you can see first crystal system is nothing but cubic. So this is the unit cell of that system. So here you can see the lengths are equal. A is equal to B is equal to C, and all the angles are at 90 degree. Alpha, beta, gamma is at 90 degree. So like this unit cell will appear. All the sides are equal and all the angles are 90 degree. Okay. So second is here tetragonal system. So tetragonal system consists of A is equal to B but not equal to C. So whatever this height is there, height is more, but bottom two sides are equal. So height is more and all the angles are at 90 degree. So like this unit cell will appear. Now third type is orthorhombic. So here all the three sides are different. A is not equal to B, not equal to C, but angles are at 90 degree. Now fourth type is rhombohedral. So it has all the sides equal, but angles are different. They are not at 90 degree. They may be 85 degree, 95 degree, 100 degree. So like this image will appear. So this is unit cell of rhombohedral. Next, fifth system is hexagonal system. It consists of two sides are equal, bottom two sides are equal, but the vertical side, that is C, is not equal. It is having much higher length, as well as two angles are at 90 degree and one angle is at 120 degree. Okay, so like this hexagonal is there. Sixth number is monoclinic. So here all the three sides are at different. A is not equal to B, not equal to C, and one angle is different here. Beta is not equal to 90 degree. Alpha and gamma are at equal angles, that is 90 degree. So this is monoclinic system. And last one is triclinic system. Here all the sides are different and all the angles are different. So like this unit cell will get formed. So this is called as triclinic system. So like this there are seven systems are there. We will repeat again names. First is cubic crystal system. Second one is tetragonal system. Third one is orthorhombic system. Fourth one is rhombohedral system. Fifth one is hexagonal system. Sixth is monoclinic system. And seventh, triclinic system. So you have to remember these names, as well as axial lengths and their angles and the diagram of that unit cell. So this is very important thing to remember. So thank you so much. So we'll cover the remaining part of this chapter in next lecture. So thank you so much.